So hi everyone, in this session we are going to see physical layer in detail. Okay, when we studied OSI layer, we saw that different layer has different responsibilities, and we discussed all the responsibilities of all layers in very brief. And now from onwards we are going to see each and every layer in detail. Okay, so let's start with physical layer. As you can see in this figure, the frame which was generated in the data link layer, the frame has data in the form of binary, right? It is in the frame has data in the form of binary, and you cannot transmit binary data. So if you want to transmit frame, you cannot directly transmit it. You want to convert that binary data, you have to convert that bits into signals so that you can transmit that signal to the receiver. So there are different type of signal we can generate. We can generate optical signals. In the case of optical fibers, we can generate electromagnetic signals. In the case of wireless transmission, we can generate electrical signals. In the case of cables, right? So there are different type of signals we can generate if we want to send data from the one place to another. So it is a responsibility of the physical layer that what kind of data you want to generate and what kind of signal you want to convert. Okay, there are different type of options are available. So it is a responsibility of the physical layer. As you know that the physical layer, it is the first layer of the OSI layer. Okay, and it defines hardware equipment, cabling, wiring, frequency and pulses. Now, signal. There are two types of signals, digital signal and analog signal. What is the difference between digital signal and analog signal? That analog signal, it is continuous in nature, right? And the digital signal, it is discrete in nature. So you can have in the analog signal, you can have multiple voltage levels. But in the digital signal, in most of the cases, you'll be having 0 volt or 5 volt means discrete voltages. There are no continuous signals in the digital, right? Now, transmission media. Transmission media, what is transmission media? It is a physical media over which the communication takes place. There are two types of transmission media, guided and unguided. Guided means wired and unguided means wireless. And the guided media again divided into three categories: twisted pair cable, coaxial and fiber optic cable. And unguided is divided into free space. Let's say twisted pair first. The twisted pair cable is made up of two plastic insulated copper wires twisted together to form a single media. So as you can see that the twisted pair cable, two cables are twisted together, and this is copper, right? And it is insulated with plastic. Now, as you can see that in the twisted pair cable, the signal is sent in the form of differential signal. Now, what is differential signal? So, for example, if this line carries, for example, 5 volt, this line carries 5 volt, and suppose that this line carries 3 volt. Okay, so the output of this twisted pair cable is taken as differential signal. So difference of these two cables, So the output of this cable is 2 volt. Okay, so whatever the voltage is flowing in the wires, output will be always be taken as differences of these two cables, right? So you may be thinking that what is the disadvantage of this mechanism? Okay, so for example, assume that there is a noise in the environment, like there is a place where twisted pair cable is applied and the environment is very noisy. So what happens due to environment, that one voltage is added. Now one voltage is added, it means that if this cable is carrying 3 volt and due to the noise, the voltage will be 4 volt. And due to noise, 1 volt is added, so this cable will be carrying 6 volt. Okay, so as you can see that in the input we are giving, we are applying 5 volt and 3 volt, but due to the noise, the signal, the cable is carrying 6 volt and 4 volts. So as you can, as you see that the voltage level are changed, but as we are taking difference of this cable, the output will be 2 volt only, right? So because we are taking difference, even though noise is added, it will be not affected at all. So this is why twisted pair cable are more prone to noise. Okay, we can if using twisted pair cable, noise can be avoided. Okay, now there are two type of twisted pair cables, shielded twisted pair STP and unshielded twisted pair. As you can see that the unshielded twisted pair has plastic insulator and copper copper cables, and there is plastic insulator. Okay, in the shielded there is extra layer of metal shield is added. Okay, so we can it provides more protection to noise. As you can see here, this is the example of unshielded twisted pair and it is a shielded twisted pair. So this is the extra layer of metal shield, right? This twisted pair cable you can see in your LAN cables. If you open your LAN cables, you can find 4 pairs of cable which are twisted together. The second type is a coaxial cable. This type of cable, you can see this type of table cable in your television. Okay, behind your television there is a coaxial cable, and in the coaxial cable there is a copper wire which is insulated by plastic insulation. Again, there is a copper mesh and outside insulation, right? The coaxial cable uses 3 type of connectors: the BNC connector, BNC T connector, and BNC terminator. Now, let's see the third type. The fiber optic. Okay, so in the fiber optic there are 3 components: a light source, a transmission medium, and light detector. Okay, as a light source we are using laser, or we can use LEDs which are light emitting diodes, and for the communication medium we are using glass, and for the light detector we are using photo detectors. Okay, so for example, if you want to transmit bits, so the first of all the light source will convert those bits into light, and the medium will carry that light, and at the receiver side there will be photo detector. Okay, it will convert again optical signal into electrical signals. This is a working principle of optical fiber that you may have studied in earlier semesters, that when the light is passing from the denser medium to less dense medium, it will move away from the normal. So in the first figure, as you can see, that the light is passing from the denser to less dense medium, and the light is moving away from the normal, and this phenomenon is known as refraction, right? This is refraction. In the second figure, you can see that the light is moving from the denser medium to less dense medium, but now the angle of incident is equal to critical angle. So in the first case, the angle of incident was less than the critical angle, so there is refraction. But when the angle of incident is equal to critical angle, the light will follow the path between two medium, right? And in the last case, if the angle of incident is greater than the critical angle, so there will be total internal reflection. So if you want to transmit a signal via the optical cable, so this is the requirement, that there should be total internal reflection, right? So angle of incidence should be always greater than the critical angle. Now, the propagation modes of fiber, there are two types of mode, multimode and single mode. The multimode is further divided into step index and graded index. Now, what is single mode and multimode? So in the single mode, there will be only one signal which will be transmitting in the cable, right? In the multimode, there will be more than one signals in the optical fiber, right? So as you can see in the figure, in the single mode, the core is very small with respect to cladding, and the core is very small, so only one signal can pass through the optical fiber, right? But in the multimode, the size of the core is very large, so that more than one signal can be transmitted, right? And this multimode is further divided into two types, step and graded index, and it is divided on the base of the refraction index of core. So if the refraction index of core is continuous, then it will be known as graded index, and the refraction index of core is discrete, then it is known as step index. Let's see figure so that you can have clear idea. That as you can see that in the step index, the refraction index of core has changed, and change is in manner of steps, so there are discrete change. But in graded index, as you can see in the graded index, that the refraction index of core is increasing if we are moving towards the center, and if we are moving away from the center, then refraction index of core is decreasing, right? So depending on the refraction index of core, if a change is continuous, then it is known as graded index, and if the change is discrete, then it is known as step index, right? This is a wireless transmission. There are three forms of wireless transmission: radio wave, microwave, and infrared. Okay, this is the electromagnetic spectrum from 3 kilohertz to 300 gigahertz, right? Now, if the frequency of wave is in range of kilohertz or megahertz, Then communication will be the radio, like AM radio, FM radio, right? And if the frequency of the signal is in gigahertz, then the communication will be like for mobile phone, satellite, then after the microwave, etc. Let's see one by one. The radio transmission, right? So radio frequency is easier to generate because of its large wavelength, and it can penetrate through walls. And if radio waves having lower frequency, then it can travel through walls. But if it has higher frequency, then it can reflect back. So now, as you can see in the figure, that it is an example of ground propagation, that if the frequency of the signal is lower than 2 megahertz, then the signal will follow the curvature of Earth. But if the signal is in range of 2 to 30 megahertz, then it can reflect through the ionosphere, right? So it can reflect, so we can use ionosphere for the communication, right? The second type is a microwave, and in the microwave, the signal frequency is above 100 megahertz. Okay, so generally microwaves are in the range of gigahertz, and it can be in the microwave communication, the sender and the receiver must be aligned if the communication is line of sight. And we cannot use ionosphere for the microwave signals because the frequency is very high. Frequency is in gigahertz. So when you transmit, if you try to use ionosphere for reflection, so it will pass through ionosphere, right? Signal will be not reflected back to Earth. So we cannot use ionosphere in the case of microwave. And the last one is a infrared, and the infrared waves lies between the visible light spectrum and microwave spectrum, and it is very useful for short range communication, for example the television remote. So this is it for physical layer. Thank you.